interest rate can never go up. Worry-free because your interest rate can go down. And because it's from Old National, you are assured a fast, dependable service. The guaranteed worry-free home mortgage. That's the kind of foundation you can build on. Just what you'd expect from your bank for life.
With exceptional web service traction. Michelin, because so much is riding on your tire. And if a Michelin X8 or any other passenger car tire you purchase from Southern Indiana Tire becomes unserviceable under normal driving conditions during the first year at 12,000 miles, Southern Indiana Tire will replace it absolutely free. That's a no-hassle warranty only from Southern Indiana Tire, the different tire store.
Going on, one of the best routines. That little guy or gal, I think it's a guy, they'll be telling him about what the chicken did to him. Cute little fellow. Take, rattle, and roll. The chicken, don't roll her. Good kid.
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, and he beats him. 54, the chicken's been entertaining in what has been a pretty entertaining basketball game. Phil Robinson politicking for some votes. That official, Dean, I had as a gym instructor at Mount Carmel High School. I said, what are you doing now?
He doesn't appear to be that old.
No. Be careful. He is still teaching and refereeing in the Big Ten.
Is he? He's done a pretty good job tonight. We'll have to keep our eye on him.
He is an average.
He didn't shoot you that jump shot of yours, did he?
No.
Okay.
I take full credit for that. Aces now. Well, try to get back. They're down by 9. Brooklyn. Martin Simmons with a rebound.
Good defensive play that time by Godfrey over with the help.
I'm sure some Aces fans are saying, boy, what if they'd have played like this the last 3 ball games? Down to 5:20, and it's a 7-point spread, 58-51, as Brooklyn walks it across. The Aces refusing to fold here. Kevin Holland and Dan Godfrey brings it down.
And this is as close as the Aces can get. A pretty long time. Let's go back. It'll be about 12 minutes to go in the first half.
Great feed from Curtis to Scott Hapner, and he draws the foul. Curtis Jackson with an excellent pass. This is worth a repeat.
Curtis with a good look inside. Gets Scott, and boy, Scott just does not get to the free throw line very much. Boy, there you can see what a fine pass that was. And the foul there, Scott going to the free throw line.
There's the center pole. He's showing the students, but Scott Hapner, with more serious things on his mind, puts in a free throw.
Hapner, an 83% free throw shooter on the season. 89 over the last 5 games, but he hasn't gone to the line much.
58-52. Green, they sure know where to look. What a drive, in and out. Godfrey looks for the release. Simmons has it. He'll take it all the way on a foul.
Marty Simmons says, I am not going to be denied. We're going to win this game. And if we don't, I am certainly going to play as hard as I can. And you see right there, boy, I tell you, Marty Simmons would touch the defenders. Switching goes up, gets the foul, still tries to get it up. But can't. And he'll go to the free throw line to shoot a couple of free throws.
4:28 on the clock. The foul was on Terrence Green. We're coming back. 58-52.
Much has been published by the insurance industry recently about our society being too happy. The simple truth is that the vast majority of clients at Robert John & Associates never see the inside of a courtroom. That's because we believe in settling cases, if possible, as quickly and reasonably as is practical. If we file suit, it's because you, the client, instruct us to do so.
Robert.
4:28 remaining. 58-52. They're cooking, rocking the chicken with the home cheerleading DePaul Blue Demon.
Mike, I talked to the Aces coaching staff before the game, and I asked them how important tempo was going to be to this game. I said, do you really want to run up and down with DePaul? And they said, hey, if we have the break, we will take it. And Marty did a good example that last time up the floor when he saw it was a one-on-two situation. He did have Curtis on one of the wings, but basically it was a one-on-two that he could split the defense. And that is a good move when a guy that can split the defenders like that and go towards the bucket. You're a strong Marty Simmons, and you're a good free throw shooter. You take it to the bucket. That's what he should have done, and he got two free throws out of it.
Marty can't convert on the first one. Jim Cruz just told his guide, Hafner and Dawson, he should go four timeouts. That's some of the distraction, but Mr. Simmons puts it in.
The Aces, if they'd hit their free throws, would be in this game. Would be right even with them. They're 6-12 on the night.
Joey Meyer up off, wanting up the bench, wanting a foul. DePaul may run a little off the clock. Stolen by Dawson.
Great defensive play that time by Belka.
Aces down by five. Bring it down with 4 minutes remaining.
Belka's been kind of quiet tonight.
Aces are starting to stand just a little bit, Mike. Jackson draws the foul on Terrence Green.
Terrence says, what did I do? And Terrence will show you what you did. You hit him right on the arm. In fact, it may not have been you. It might have been Kevin Holland. Green might have had a good drive there. I think it might have been number 15, Kevin Holland, that got him. Let's see.
It was. But they gave it to Green. But Curtis, once again, misses the front end. It remains 58-53, 3:42 on the clock. Jackson with his first point of the night. He averages 6 points, but has not played much on this current road trip. Edwards. Green gets him up. Battling strong on an eight. Saved by the Aces. Great effort. So again, they'll bring it down. Now they can pull within two or one. 58-54. Simmons, they got it in the right hand.
Nice play by Marty that time. Great look that time by Velcro down the floor. And boy, the Aces bend over and touch the floor and say, let's play some defense.
3 minutes, 2:56 remaining. A tremendous comeback by the Aces. They trail by as much as 13 on two different occasions. They're back within two. And he throws it away. And in unison, the UE bench is up. That's the Joey Meyer says, hey, I told you this would be tough.
DePaul hasn't scored for nearly 3.5 minutes. The Aces trailed by 9 points at the time. They trail by two now and could either tie it or take the lead with a three-pointer.
Again, into the right hand, goaltending. The basket is good. And DePaul wants a timeout. We're tied 58-58. Take another look.
Great Marty Simmons move right there, and Holland goes up. He gets it after it hits the board. And that is automatically goaltending, and we are tied 58-58, 2.5 minutes left.
We'll start it over in a moment.
Achievement begins with a single step. The higher we climb, the more we become. That's why Alcoa supports quality education in our community by donating funds for new buildings and materials for vocational classes, and by sponsoring projects aimed at minority and special students. There's no limit to what can be accomplished by helping others reach the top. Alcoa, dedicated to keeping the spirit of achievement alive. At Old National Bank, the bus stop with Marty Schumann.
Folks and movers like doing business here at home. And with Old National Movers, you never have to go out of your way to bank. Not even for a home improvement loan.
The bus stop with Dave McLaughlin.
Bill Flagley, you got the green light on everything from loans to money market accounts. That means you can do all your banking in one easy stop. Right here on Greenville Road and get back on your way again.
Minutes, 28 seconds remaining. The Aces, what a tremendous comeback. My, oh my, would this be an upset? Coming in on a three-game losing streak, the Aces trail by 6.5, down by 13, midway through the second half, has pulled dead even, 58 all.
I was talking to the trainer, Steve Dayton, for the Aces, and he looked at me and he says, you know, there's a lot of upsets in college basketball. Now, why couldn't we come in here and upset DePaul tonight? And I said, well, Steve, I hope you're right. And, boy, they're in a very good position. Attendance tonight, we talked about it, over 13,000, 13,140.
Strickland with a forced shot, Hafner with a rebound. He goes down, no whistle, finally a whistle, and a jump ball. Aces certainly didn't get a break there. Down to 2:03.
The ball's up complaining on that too. I think they said they wanted to foul with Strickland going across. They said, no, the hand was on top of the ball. Simmons went down, Godfrey went down. Godfrey playing with four fouls.
Lost will bring it in, 2:03 on the clock. We're tied at 58. Strickland.
You go to your money man, and Mr. Strickland put two down that time.
A minute 45, Ultra looking for help. They're now very much into the ball game. Simmons, back to Godfrey. Hafner pulls the trigger. A big one. We're tied again at 125. Make that 3 points.
That is the first Aces lead since it was 20-18 with 6 minutes to go in the first half.
Battle underneath and a foul.
I think that's going to be on Marty. If it is, it's his third. Take another look at it. And you see Holland doing a good job. He's played a lot of minutes tonight. Goes up to Marty underneath, and Marty says, oh, I was sitting there, ref.
Here's the scenario, 61-60. Kevin Holland goes to the line, where he is shooting 62%.
Boy. Mr. Holland in the final 2 minutes of the game, or in overtime this season, 5 of 15, only 33%.
And Hafner with a rebound. A minute 12. Dawson all the way. Godfrey's there with a rebound. Godfrey, 63, 61, you lead. We're down to 55. Aces on the verge of a great upset. Kevin Edwards, strong move in the basket. 40 seconds. They're going to walk it up slowly.
The shot clock is off, Mike. The Aces can take the last shot if they want.
They're on their feet at the Rosemont Horizon.
I think Jim Cruz is going to say, let's go ahead and run it. I'm not going to toss on that. You guys do what you want. He says, nope.
15 seconds.
Look for Simmons.
Down to 10. Here we go. Jackson.
National Bank, we've got the perfect foundation for your new home. It's the guaranteed worry-free home market. Guaranteed because your interest rate can never go up. Worry-free because your interest rate can go down. And because it's from Old National, you are assured a fast, dependable service. The guaranteed worry-free home market. That's the kind of foundation you can build on. Just what you'd expect from your bank for life.
Plays along with Dean Webster live here at the Rosemont Horizon. His final score on an incredible comeback, 65-63. With no time, with actually about 1 second on the clock, Godfrey with the putback. Dean, if ever Erie needed a win, tonight was it, and what a win against one of the premier independents in this country.
I thought 13 was supposed to be an unlucky number. That was Dan Godfrey. Well,
then he took a seat with 10:03 with his third foul. He comes back. He was the difference down the stretch. Had another key move right at the end.
He really opens the play up because, in fact, we talked a couple of weeks ago to Jim Molinari, the assistant coach for DePaul, the halftime of the Troy game, or the Loyola game. And he said, I'm really impressed with the way Godfrey has come along. He said, and we don't match up very well with Godfrey inside, and he wasn't pulling our leg. They really didn't.
Also, bringing in Curtis Jackson. You needed somebody to penetrate right at the end. Curtis takes it to the hole strongly.
You got to give DePaul credit. They played some good defense that time, and they said, we're going to make a guy drive, but we don't think he can hit the bucket. Curtis made the drive. He got the ball up.
Here it is, incidentally. Let's take another look.
Okay, Curtis goes up, and you see he throws it up there, but he was trying to get it up on the board. He knew there might be a rebounder there. He had to get it up on the board. You see they're trying to call timeout there. The official puts his hand up, but there's no time left on the clock.
That victory for the Aces. A tremendous victory. Incidentally, the Aces now come home. What way to come home? They will be at the stadium on Wednesday night to take on the Marquette Warriors. They return to conference play a week from tonight. We'll be there as well at Xavier. Xavier's laying on the grass waiting for the Aces in one of the most exciting games probably prior to this one, where, of course, Marty Simmons and Gummy winning it with no time on the clock. Xavier will be out for revenge. But what a way to come home.
I thought we might get a chance to talk to Dan Godfrey. I think we might quickly get him out here real quick. We got a couple of minutes left. Yeah, I mean, you just can't say enough about this young man. He came here out of Stillman Valley, Illinois. He comes in and redshirts his first year here. He worked very hard back here. He's worked very hard in the summers. And it's really a credit to the whole Aces team, the way they've helped him and the way he's been included in the office. And he really came through at a crucial time. What was your thoughts among the Jim Crew's victory?
I would say it has to be right up there, pretty close to the top.
Boy, it sure does. And I'm sure he would trade three conference wins for this, but under the circumstances, this was a tremendous victory. Going back, coming in with a billing like this, you got guys like Strickland, Green, Grundy, three good athletes. Were you as impressed with Strickland? Was he as good as the media guide and everything said he would be?
He controls the game. He just takes the ball and he never loses control of himself. He's always in total control of himself and he's in control of the game.
Well, the Aces certainly are in control of things tonight. What a comeback. Again, recapping some of the scoring, Marty Simmons with 11 first half points. Good ball game, but the Aces trail 31-25. Came back, but then fell behind by the score of 50-37. It's also, I think, 52-39.
They trailed, yeah, by 13 points. And we thought at that time, you know, we even made the comment, you know, it's not time to panic yet. They were down 10 points just 7 minutes to go. And we said, it's really not time to panic yet. You know, with the Aces offense, and I think I even mentioned the Aces offense is really clicking tonight, and it really got going at the end.
Boy, oh boy. They are back. This is the team that left Roberts Stadium 2 weeks ago.
Let's not forget a big three-pointer by Scott Hafner down the stretch. He was a very important three-pointer to put the Aces up.
Absolutely. Well, it's been a happy outcome. Again, don't forget, Wednesday night, Aces home. That will be against Marquette. And then we'll take you to Xavier a week from tonight. That will be for the Xavier game. And also, we've got another game coming at home with Detroit as they conclude their final homestand of the season.
you made the comment, it's a shame the Aces couldn't play with that kind of intensity over the last three games. But I think the fans saw tonight the Aces team that is truly there and the team that is capable of really showing up and really playing well. This was a win probably similar to the one that was at Northern Iowa, an awfully big win on the road. Not really the adverse conditions that they had here, but still a hostile crowd, over 13,000. And anytime you can come into a place like this and come away with a victory, hey, hats off to them.
The Aces are coming home. A happy winner tonight. Final outcome here at the Rosemont Horizon. Huey wins it, 65-63. Good night, everybody, from Chicago. Exciting University of Evansville basketball. Tonight's game between the U of E Purple Aces and the Butler Bulldogs is brought to you in part by Old National Bank, your bank for life. E. Patrick, where the world's great cars are. King's Superstore, 4225 East Morgan in Evansville. Ford and your local Ford dealer. Robert John and Associates, attorneys at law. And by Easter, your hardware store, and more.
Just a few frogs from a small Newberg office. Some 30 years later, Bernhardt's company has grown into Tite Home Center, Evansville's largest locally owned lumber company. Tite now offers 11 acres of quality building material. Our services include a complete residential design department, two full-time draftsmen, experienced color consultants, and an expert sales staff. Quality, selection, and service. The tradition continues at Tite Home Center, Evansville, Newburgh, and Rockport.
For the starting lineup for tonight, and now let's go to the Butler PA announcer and get the starting lineup. Go to. Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Hinkle Fieldhouse for tonight's the Western Collegiate Conference game featuring the Evansville Purple Aces and the Butler Bulldogs. Now let's meet the starting lineup for tonight's game. At one forward for the Aces, a 6'6" senior from Lawrenceville, Illinois, number 50, Marty Simmons. At one forward for the Bulldogs, a 6'5" freshman from Noblesville, number 34, John Carappa. At the other forward for Evansville, a 6'7" sophomore from Baltimore, Maryland, number 42, Brian Hill. At the other forward for Butler, a 6'4 sophomore from Fort Wayne, number 52, Rick Donovan. At center for the Aces, a 6'9 sophomore from Stillman Valley, Illinois, number 53, Dan Godfrey. At center for the Bulldogs, a 6'8 senior from Cloverdale, number 31, Chad Tucker. One guard for Evansville, a 6'4 junior from Noblesville, number 3, Scott Hafner. At one guard for Butler, a 6'6 junior from Joliet, Illinois, number 12, Darren Folt. And at the other guard for the Aces, a 6'1 senior from Highland Park, Illinois, number 10, Beltra Johnson. And at the other guard for the Bulldogs, a 6'4 junior from Houston, Illinois, number 22, Thad Mata. Coach of the Purple Aces is Jim Cruz. Coach of the Bulldogs is Joe Sexton.
Scheduled to start tonight's game was supposedly was supposed to be Rick Berry for the Butler Bulldogs, but he is a little ill, so he is unable to play. We are ready to go with second place on the line, and normally don't think second place means much. Not so in the Midwestern Collegiate Conference, at least this year, when they have 16. Dayton, of course, will join the league next year, where there will be 7, so it'll just be one team with a bye. Skipped around, and Marty Simmons comes away with it, and now Scott Hafner has it to start the game. The Aces come in with a 2-4 conference record and 16-6 overall. Butler 13-9 overall and a 5-3 conference record. And the first 3 points of the game are by Scott Hafner on a three-pointer, shooting 45% from there on the season. And he starts out with the hot hand tonight.
Can't start any better than that.
Aces playing a good defense. And Folk steps on the line, and a turnover. Folk ran into a little problem with turnovers in the first game between these two teams. He committed 4 of the team's 13. In fact, between Folk and Tucker, they committed 9 of the team's 13 turnovers. So even though they are the catalyst on the team, they'll turn the ball over occasionally. Hafner looks for 3, gets it inside the hill, and Bryan with a strong shot, rebounded by Godfrey. A little hook is no good, and Butler comes down with it this time.
Had a couple of good shots inside, couldn't come up with a basket.
Carappa, although is not very big inside, he plays taller than he is because of his jumping ability. This is Carappa at the free throw line, and he has 6'9.5", Dan Godfrey guarding him, and he shoots it right over Godfrey, so Carappa gets the first 2 points for the Bulldogs, with 3-2 Aces. Inside the Godfrey, and then tried
to shoot it off the pass. He didn't really have a good shot at all. He was kind of in the air when he let go of the ball.
Folks can shoot from any place, inside and outside. And like the first game, that Robert Stadium, Scott Hafner, has started out on defense on Chad Tucker, and Tucker gets his first 2 points tonight, and the Bulldogs have a 4-3 lead. Dan, already apparent the Aces want to try to get the ball inside tonight.
That's right. They want to get a lot of easy baskets inside. They do want to get a lot of open shots outside, but they certainly want to work it in inside and try to get Tucker and Colts into some foul trouble.
The Aces are coming off a loss, of course, Saturday night to Xavier. They'd like to get back on the winning track. Hafner has it stolen by Tucker, and the Bulldogs come on the attack. This is Tucker with Simmons going to be called for the foul as he stepped in the passing lane. The official says he grabbed him on his arm. That was Larry Memories with the call. Tucker gets it in to Thad Mata. Mata is the assistant, and he will find Folks and Tucker whenever they're open, and this is Tucker. And Tucker turns it over. A good defense to pass inside.
Hill cut nicely inside. He got the open pass from Simmons.
Brian played a strong game after the game was decided on Saturday. This is Folks with Simmons falling down. And Carafa is called for the foul. Carafa is a 6'5", 210-pound freshman out of Noblesville. Strong inside player. And the Aces leading it by the score of 5-4. Will try to extend the lead. It's a big game in the MCC. Another one is in Cincinnati tonight, where the Xavier Musketeers are playing host to St. Louis. And Godfrey gets a missed shot.
He had his shot, but just couldn't hit it.
Here comes Mata with Dawson out on guard of him. Belcher has really turned into a good defensive player. A nice move. And Brian Hill is going to be called for the block. That's going to be Bill first and the team second. We're going to have some free throw shot here by John Carafa.
Coach Steve Bennett told me before the game, they just hope to contain Chad Tucker and Darren Polk, keep them at their average or below if they have a chance to win the ball game.
There is Joe Sexton talking to Rick Donovan tonight in place of Rick Berry as Carafa hits his second free throw and retired at 5. Carafa missed the first free throw at Roberts Stadium, and Butler proceeded to hit 19 straight. That is Hafner. No good. Godfrey inside. And Carafa's going to be called for the foul. I said they hit 19 straight. They hit 18 straight. Butler was 18 for 19 for the free throw line. That's the first game at Roberts Stadium.
Godfrey with really good position that time. And Butler was over his back.
Inside the Hill. Hill with a turnaround jumper. Gets his fourth point of the night. And the Aces have opened it up 7-5.
Like to see him hitting early.
He has struggled with his shot a little bit from the outside. We know about his jumping ability. And hitting the jumper from the outside, Darren Folks, and he turns around and thrusts the hand in the air and says, let's go. Butler back on top, 8-7. Just under 16 minutes to go now, first half. Simmons for three. Got it. Marty with his first point for the night, and the Aces are back on top.
So far, things are pretty much clicking on all 10 cylinders for the Aces.
Both teams have the offense going in the early going. Butler looking inside for Tucker. Polk carries the ball on the hip. And with 15 minutes and 25 seconds left first half, we've got our first timeout. It's the official one. And the Aces are leading it by the score of 10-8.
Been our family business for over 60 years. Four generations of family members who have always been committed to maintaining the highest tradition of excellence. That commitment continues today at DePaul.
It is our sincere desire to give you the best price, the best selection, and the best service on any car we sell. Commitment, that's the DePaul difference.
King Superstore sales event of Olympic proportions continues. Every single item in the store is marked to move. Get a cap and raise with a decorative black door for only $237. Color TV sells as low as $139. That's right, $139. It's wild. And treat yourself to a GE washer and dryer. Buy that pair for only $488. $488 a pair. Free delivery, 90 days, cash, home financing with no money down. It's King sales event of Olympic proportions. Don't miss it at King Superstore. 4225 East Morgan. Nobody beats King's deal.
Even though the Aces are leading game, they have been outshot by Butler. Evansville 4 of 9, Butler 3 of 4.
Basically because of the three-point shot by Hafner and Simmons, able to make up for that. And we are ready to go. Belcher Dawson setting offense against a 2-3 Butler zone. Godfrey is hammered inside before the shot, and it's going to be on number 12, Dan Folk.
There's no doubt they're going inside either Hill or Godfrey with those easy points.
As we said, Rick Berry out with the flu, so Rick Donovan is in there. Donovan, only 6'4", basically playing center, and he cannot stop that dunk by Brian Hill. And Hill has 6 points already in this game.
Real nice alley-oop at that time.
Davis is covering up nicely on defense. He's Simmons and got some help there from Godfrey. Tucker, I bet he's going to be called for the push-off, and he is. Scott Hacker doing a nice job of turning him that time.
Tucker's a tough guy to guard, but Hacker will have his work cut out for him.
Why would they put someone, Dan, like 6'4", on someone 6'8", like that?
Well, they realize that Tucker's going to get his points. Why sign Marty Simmons or somebody like that out against a guy like Tucker?
Inside again, Brian Hill for another deuce, and Brian is cooking. He's got 8 points. He had 19 in the first meeting between these two teams this year on 8 of 9 shooting. And he is hot tonight. And hot on the other side is Dan Folk. And Folk picks up his 5th point of the night. And it's a 14-10 Aces lead.
Nice move inside by Folk.
Really smooth operator, isn't he?
He sure is.
Hafner fakes the three and goes to the baseline. And inside the Hill again. And this time a charging foul is going to be called on Hill. And Brian grabs his knee as he goes down. And the Aces don't need another injury with Curtis Jackson already out of action for the rest of the season.
Hill, a little too determined that time to go inside. Hill moving inside, obvious position. And he is called for the offensive foul on Carafa. Number 2 on Brian Hill.
So Brian with the early offense, but also the early foul trouble. And Milt Donald has stepped into the lineup here.
Milt Donald more in there for his defense than anything else right now.
And the guy known for his offense is Darren Folks, and he's keeping the Bulldogs in it. The Aces lead cut to 2 points. Milt Donald, the apology being rewarded
from a good effort the other night against the Xavier Musketeers when he came off the bench. Godfrey with the short hook. Can't get it to go, and here come the Bulldogs. Jim Cruz wanted a push-off on Thad Mata, and Simmons comes up with the steal. Ahead to Donald. Will takes one dribble, decides to hold it up. Delta Dawson barking out the instructions. Donovan picks the ball away, and we'll have a new 45-second clock. We also have a new player in the lineup, and that is John Soup, a 6'1", 160-pound freshman from Michigan Town, attended Clinton Central High School. This is Hoffman. Oh, this is Tucker with the rebound. Had an open shot, but just a little too hard. Simmons goes down, and Folk goes up. And that is 9 points for Darren Folk. And the Bulldogs have pulled back to a 14-14 tie at the 12-and-a-half-minute mark.
Well, Folk is the guy to stop right now, but they're not doing a very good job on it.
Aces look a little confused offensively right now, Dan. Darren Folk comes up with the big block of Dan Godfrey's
shot. Folk read that one. Nice block. They went to the well once too often, I think, that time.
This is Soup, who just stepped in. And this is Folk, who's been checking out the basket all night. And called for the foul over the back of Delta Dawson is Rick Donovan. So the Bulldogs getting into a little bit of foul trouble now. For Donovan, that is his second personal. And for the team, that is number six. So the next foul will result in a 1-1 for the Aces. But right now, with 11 minutes 52 seconds left, we are tied at 14.
The Great Rebates of 88 are going on now at your Ford dealer. But hurry, it all ends March 8th. Get a $400 rebate on Ford Escort. Add a factory option package and save over $1,000. And get a $750 rebate on Ford Taurus. Then save over $1,300 when you add an option package. There's even a $1,000 rebate on Turbo Thunderbird. Add a super option package and save over $2,000. But it all ends March 8th. The Great Rebates of 88. With quality standards, your Ford dealer.
With the new Black & Decker Car Vac Plus, the most powerful car vac you made. The Black & Decker Car Vac Plus leaves everything else in the dust. Available at all 8 Keithley's locations.
The Aces had the hot hand early, especially Brian Hill, who got 8 quick points. But he also picked up 2 quick fouls, Dan.
He sure did. He has definitely been a scoring machine so far, but we'll have to watch it getting into foul trouble. The Aces shooting 43% to Butler's 75%, but the Aces and the Bulldogs remain tied.
14-14. Milt Donald getting some playing time tonight. And Curtis Jackson is home recuperating from reconstructed knee surgery. And the guy who knows about surgery is Marty Simmons, and he cut through the Butler defense that time.
Joe Sexton told me before the game they can't let Simmons or Hafner go crazy tonight if they're going to be able to win the game.
That is Folk.
Marty is a good position.
Folk is, of course, one person the Aces have to worry about. And Godfrey tipped twice at a Hafner miss. And Dan Godfrey with the dude.
Scott had a shot again. He just can't seem to find the rhythm and get the ball to go down. I think he's been in that kind of a slump for the last couple of games.
That was Godfrey's first bucket of the evening. And the Bulldogs throw it away.
Ace is playing really good man-to-man defense right now. And half Tucker is doing a heck of a job on Tucker, because Tucker right now only with 2 points. And with one quarter of the game gone and Tucker only with two, you got to like that.
Jody Littrell has stepped into the Butler attack. He is number 14. This is Godfrey at the half there. And the official said he had his toe on the line, so that was not a three-point attempt. 18-14, Aces lead. This is Littrell, good three-point shooter. But also a good man to get the ball inside to Chad Tucker.
It almost looked like Tucker pushed off on Scott, but the referee didn't see it that way. Number two on Scott, number four on the Aces.
And into the game, Olaf Blob. Olaf, the 7'6", 240-pound transfer from the University of Illinois. And he has had some trouble with a leg injury.
Coaches didn't expect him to see too much playing time tonight.
And he may be forced into a little action now. Probably everyone's going to be seeing just a few more minutes of action, Dan, because of the loss of Curtis Jackson.
Coach Steve Bennett said that Chris Bamba, Milt Donald, and Jeff Moyer are probably getting in more. Bamba to guard the post, Donald for his passing, and Jeff Morning also for his offense.
Curtis, a very versatile player. You take somebody like that out of lineup, that hurts. And this is Tucker with the miss, and Donald with the rebound. And the official caught Milt double dribbling as Donald started to pick it up, I think, and throw it to Hoffman.
Not a very good turnover right there.
Rodney Hayward getting ready to check in for the Bulldogs. Hayward has not played that much for the Bulldogs, although he did see a minute of playing time against the Aces in the first meeting at Roberts Stadium and came up with one rebound in that contest. This is John Keith. And Donald is on Polk. So Milt getting thrown to the wolves early as he gets a tough defensive assignment and Darren Polk inside. Tucker with a little push off inside, no call. He misses the shot and here come the Aces. The crowd wanted the turnover with traveling.
They might have been right.
Joe Sexton wanted it as well. This is Hoffner out of the corner. Scott Hoffner with a 6 point, both on three-pointers. And the Aces lead it by 7, 21-14. They've run off 7 straight.
The Aces are working the ball inside, getting the zone to collapse, and working it back outside for the open jumper.
Inside goes Polk. And Donald is called for the foul.
That was a foul.
Got his money's worth on that one. And watch the defense converge on Darren Folks inside.
Folks has been lighting it up, and he works inside again. And Donald obviously reaching and slapping him on the hand, and Olaf kind of came along to help.
I think he might have been 3 fouls on that play. Darren Folks, the second team All-NCC performer a year ago.
And you're looking at the best free throw shooting team in the country. And, of course, they missed their first shot.
Mata won for two a while ago. And Folks misses one here. And the Aces continue to substitute freely. Back into the lineup, Godfrey and Hill. So the Aces are back with their original starting lineup, and the Bulldogs are going to apply a little pressure in the backcourt.
This is exactly the way the Aces wanted it to be right at this moment. In this kind of a position, they're playing their game.
Olsiak says, you took a couple of stutter steps there, young man.
A little anxious getting that shot off.
Joe Sexton stands up and says, let's run play number three. That was Haywood. Rodney Haywood. This is Simmons. Inside, nice pass from Hoffman to Godfrey. Godfrey hammered inside, up with the tip. Inside, Tucker comes down with the rebound.
They converged on Godfrey pretty well.
Oh,
15. Beautiful move by Scott, avoiding the charge.
For his first regular bucket of the night, he's had 2 3-pointers. He's got 8. This is Jody Litchell from Columbus East High School. And Colts is rejected inside. Belcher with a fadeaway gets it to go. Not a good shot by Belcher Dawson, but gets it to go down. Belcher's first 2 points of the night.
We'll take it.
AC's biggest lead of the night at 10.
Man again, and they have really kept Chad Tucker quiet. If he wakes up, it's going to be a different game, but right now he has not done anything except to score 2 points.
There will be a timeout at the next dead ball. That is why the Bulldogs are not calling a timeout to stop the Aces' run. They have outscored Butler 11-1 now, but was tied at 14 all.
Rick Barry into the game, and he has been suffering from the flu, as you said earlier, and Coach Joe Sexton says he's about 75%, so he's not at his best.
I know all about suffering from the flu, I'm telling you. Chris Bombay, as you mentioned, a few players are going to see some more playing time with the absence of Curtis Jackson. And actually, the Curtis Jackson playing time will be split up among 3 players. Is that about right?
Yeah. Bamba, Donald, and Morning will get most of the work.
Colts with 11, and he has his number on his back of 12. And the Aces lead it now by 8 points, 25-17. We're coming back right after this.
Now at Risley, experience true Olympic performance in every quality stock video cassette and accessory product. The stock recording kit for the Olympics. $16.99 after rebate. Scott's Easy All-Purpose Video Cassette, just $2.79 after rebate. And Scott's Video Head Cleaner, only $8.99 after rebate. Talk to the Olympics on Scott's Video Cassette, the official video cassette of the 1988 Olympic Games from 3M. At Risley, the high-performance edge.
Dave Leonard. Since 1895, hard at work with new ideas in heating and cooling. And now, give 0% financing and $100 cash rebate on the efficient Lennox pulse gas furnace. Call your independent Lennox dealer.
How to give you hard-earned money to utility companies?
Call Montgomery & Webb in Owensboro for high-efficiency Lennox products that can earn you big dollars in fuel savings every year.
Quality equipment, expert installation, and top service. That's Montgomery & Webb.
Attaboy, Dave. The Aces leading it by the score of 25-17, 7 minutes, 21 seconds left to go in the first half. And right now, the Aces are pretty much doing what they want as far as the offense is going, Dan. They look pretty good.
They really do, and they're staying right on their objective so far. One of the keys going into tonight was showing patience on offense and getting inside the defense, and they have done that. And when they've been clogged up inside, they've shot the ball back out front to Simmons and Hoffner, and although Hoffner's been a little cold, he has hit a couple of shots here in the last few minutes.
Jim Curry said Saturday night after the game, he said, we just can't play average or especially poor and win a ball game. He said, we have to do things well in order to win. And they have done things well 16 times this year and not so well 6. 16-6 for the Aces as they break the pressure.
It looked like he was on the line, but no call.
Very close. As the Aces turn it over.
Oh,
a big call there, Dan, as there's a foul on Darren Folks inside.
It's his first foul. So we'll go back the other way, and the Aces have got to like their position right now, up by 8.
And the Aces are in the bonus, as is Butler. So Chris Bamba. Chris, a year ago, was a pretty good free throw shooter, Dan, and he has kind of changed his style a little bit this year, and he is only at 46% on the air, but he hit that one.
Well, the shooting percentages have changed since the last time we gave you the statistics. That has gone out 500, Butler at 42%, 43%, 6 of 14.
I talked about what a poor free throw shooter Chris Bamba was, and he hit two of them.
Kushner still on Tucker inside, and Bamba now has the floor of guarding Darren Polk. This is Litchell, and this is Polk. And Godfrey gets a big rebound, and here come the Aces, and a foul on Chad Tucker.
Butler now missed their last eight field goal attempts.
Tucker from behind gave Marty Simmons a show, and Tucker is not at all happy, and neither is Joe Jackson.
Well, Tucker, it's another key to the game so far. Tucker with only 2 points.
They have really kept him quiet. There is the guy that does a fine job.
He might be getting a little frustrated right now.
And for Tucker, that is an awfully big call because that is Chad Tucker's third personal foul.
He's going to have to sit down.
He will go out now with 6 minutes and 44 seconds to go. And Jim Cruz talks about that knockout punch, and you never know when it's going to come, and the Aces could do it here with maybe Mr. Tucker on the bench.
That's not to tear it away, but if the Aces continue to play the way they have, it is a possibility.
An 11-point Aces lead as Simmons goes back to the free throw line and hit the pair. And the Aces now have their biggest lead of 29-17.
And they've also taken the crowd out of the game. Butler looks a little bit confused on offense. Not really running it very smoothly.
This is Mata. Oh, from three. And Godfrey with another rebound, and here come the Aces. Dawson takes it to the hoop, puts it up. No good. And Carafa is called for the foul.
Dawson had Simmons on the wing, but waited a little bit too long to dish off.
Delta has not really taken a couple of bad shots now off the break.
He got one to fall, but that one did not. By the way, Butler now 0-9, the last 9 attempts.
Ooh. And more substitutions because of foul trouble for Butler. As another starter, John Carafa, another frontline player for Butler, goes down. He now has 3 fouls. And Chris Bamba will go back to the free throw line where he just hit 2 moments ago. This is Simmons, and Godfrey with another rebound.
You like to see that.
Godfrey really pulling the rebound.
Simmons will try it again.
Marty, not basketball out of the corner.
Boy, they had a shot there to put on that knockout punch a little bit.
Boy, you figure when you get Simmons out of the corner twice from three-point line, he's going to connect on one of the two.
Cruz claiming that Bamba had his hands up, and that wasn't a foul, but it was not seen that way by the official.
Jim Cruz says, how can you call a foul if my man had his hands straight up? And here, Jim Cruz is saying, here right now as Darren Polk hits another free throw.
Well, that ends a dry spell for Butler. Long dry spell.
Polk has 13, make it 14 points and 5 free throws. So Darren Polk is the Butler offense right now. Tucker has a field goal, Carafa has a field goal, and Mata has a free throw. The Aces have done what they feel, a better job of substituting tonight as they have gotten 8 players into the game.
Scott trying to get the ball inside as the Aces continue to work it.
Bamba, Blob, and Donald of all screen action. The Aces will have to pick it up a notch with a loss of Curtis Jackson, and we said in the pregame we'd like to pass our well wishes along to Curtis.
Boy,
hope he is better soon.
Great hustle by Dawson.
Delta with a good defensive play, and the Aces bench up applauding the pass.
didn't get position on the defensive rebound, and Butler was all over the place.
Now the second foul.
And Brett Efferson, a 6'7", 200-pound freshman from Russellville, a student at Western High School.
That was his first miss in MCC free throw shooting. And he was also, too, the best free throw shooting team in the nation.
He was an Indiana All-Star a year ago. He did not have All-Star form on those free throws. After a bad pass inside to Godfrey, but Dan with a nice dish out to Marty, and this is Belcher Dawson. And Belcher now has 3 field goals and 6 points, and the Aces have their biggest lead at 33-19, a 14-point advantage.
That's his jump shot. That's the shot he needs to take.
Have that 3-point range.
No. They rush that shot.
Mitchell with the misfire, and here come the Aces.
Dawson this time gives it up on the break. Good hands by Marty.
We're watching WFIE Channel 14 in Evansville. And it is 33-19 Aces. And Marty Simmons buries his head, and I don't know if he got poked in the eye there, or
it looks like it. He's grabbing his face.
Let's take another look at him.
So Simmons going inside. He had a crowd conversion on him. And again, the left hand of...
Is that Barry?
Yeah, Rick Barry got Simmons in the eye, but he looks all right. He's shaking it off, and he'll go to the line.
Rick Barry with one of those hooks off that 6'8", 220-pound frame. Knocks Marty in the face, but doesn't bother Simmons at the free throw line. As Marty gets his 8th point of the night, and he hits his 3rd free throw.
The absence of Chad Tucker is almost eerie.
And the Aces have now taken it to a 16-point advantage when Tucker left at the 6:44 mark. It was a 10-point Aces lead. And Butler coach Joe Sexton says, I think we better talk it over before this one gets out of hand. Aces leaded by 16, 35-19.
When a person is injured in an accident, the entire family can feel the burden of medical expenses, property damage, or lost income. At Robert Zion Associates, there is no fee to meet with us to discuss these problems and your legal rights. There is no obligation to hire us to represent you, but you will be more informed about your rights. Should you hire us, our fee is only a fraction of your recovery. If there is no recovery, then there is no fee.
Robert John and Associates, 425-2718, no recovery, no fee.
The best is still the fastest. Smith Eddy and Kodak 35mm in about 30 minutes film processing. Bring in your film to Smith Eddy, and your complete clip will be ready in about half an hour. And under the same rigid quality control that helps Smith Eddy attain the highest rating in Kodak's prestigious color wipe system. So, when time and quality are important, check your film to Smith Eddy.
30-minute processing. Now at Bronzer East and Washington Square Mall. Come and see the Smith Eddy web.
The Aces lead it 35-19. Dan, at one point, it was 14-14, and the Aces have almost run off and left the Bulldogs.
The story's been told on the board. Lee, 18 rebounds to Butler's 10, and Godfrey, Dan Godfrey, has 8 of those rebounds, so he's a fourth inside.
Godfrey did not play very well in the first meeting between these two teams. Only had 2 points and 4 rebounds, but he had a little foul trouble. Bulldogs trying to hang on while their senior captain and leading scorer, Chad Tucker, is on the bench with 3 fouls. And Chris Bamba just leveled Brett Efferson and is called for the foul. And Bamba picks up foul number 3.
Well, Butler's working the ball to Fultz. Now, he's their hot shooter. Bamba trying to run through a pick. And he
did run through it. So Brett Efferson will go to the free throw line, where he gets a couple just a while ago. As Dan said, Butler, the leading free throw shooting team in the nation. That is pretty fair. Efferson gets this
Rangers go back inside and pop it outside. And Scott Hackman says, thank you very much. And that is his third three-pointer of the night. He has 11. Once again, his zone collapsed inside. They worked it back out to Scott and nailed it. You have to have that inside threat to have a successful outside game to open the lanes up. And that's Mata, Barry with the rebound. Barry back outside to Mata, and he decides better of taking the shot again from the outside.
Folks, and Donald in a pushing match right now.
Donald, a good defensive player. Etherington getting in a little trouble, but gets it to Folks, and Folks is having his trouble. Etherington gets it, and Scott Hackman with the rebound.
Butler can't buy a basket right now.
They really have to feel like the lid's on it right now for them.
And Milt Donald up off the bench cheering with Nate Johnson, or rather, Chris Bomber.
Hackman looking inside for Godfrey. Instead, finds Marty Simmons out of the corner, and the Aces offense clicking on all cylinders. And Marty Simmons with the three-pointer gives the Aces a 20-point, 41-21 lead.
This is a funny game.
Simmons with 12, Hackman with 11, and that's just what Joe Sexton feared would happen. He didn't want that at all, did he?
Nope.
Polk misses again, up, no good. Simmons comes down with it, and a foul on Rick Barry.
Boy, Butler has got ice cold. Polk had two easy shots inside, and he couldn't hit him.
Darren Folks just sitting underneath the basket, Dan, and just said, my gosh, what do I have to do to get it to go down?
Gets the ball away. And Tim is obviously with position and had his hands on the ball. Folks out of frustration maybe from missing the two previous shots committed the foul.
They gave the foul to Barry. They said he was over the top first before
okay.
Folks got him. And Folks, who is normally a very good field goal shooter, had his trouble the other night against St. Louis when he was 6 of 15 from the field. And the Aces have another substitute, Larry Brand, into the game. As Scott Hoffman gets a rest. And Chad Fordyce has stepped into the game. Number 42 for Butler. A lot of players have seen some first half action in this one as the Aces lead it by 23 points. And I don't think anyone expected this one, though.
No, I don't think so. And you mentioned that knockout punch earlier. We're getting close. Good pressure defense by the Aces.
Folks has his shot blocked. Brown comes down with it. We are going to talk to Joe Sexton as he comes off the floor at halftime. Dan will get a chat with him. And I don't think he's going to be a very happy man, Mr. Cash.
I don't think so. It'll be interesting to find out what he has to say.
He is always cordial. And bringing him back a little bit is Darren Folk.
That breaks the drought for him.
Folk with a three-pointer. And they have yet to put it up on the scoreboard. This is Simmons for three. Godfrey almost with a great tip in. 35 seconds to go now. And the Bulldogs are trying to cut a 19-point lead down now. Folks will look from three. Shoot from two-point land. And who are they going to call the foul on? Well, check it and see, they get Larry Brand with the first inside. And going to the free throw line will be Rick Barry. There's Brand shoving Barry from behind, getting called for the foul. Fordyce was on the ground. So Rick Barry will go to the free throw line, where he is 14 of 24 on the season at 50. They got 8 of 14 on the season for 57%, and he hits the bucket.
National Bank, the buck stops with Margo Edwards.
Who needs the mall, fast service trunk? That's what you'll get with Old National. Because I can make my own decisions, you don't get stuck waiting around.
The buck stops with Bill Fortune.
My question is, like working with someone you know. With Old National, they do. Banking here is one-on-one. It's just you or it's just me. Now, isn't that the way it ought to be?
Is your car ready to take off with the new Black & Decker Car Vac Plus, the most powerful car vac you made? The Black & Decker Car Vac Plus leaves everything else in the dust.
The great rebates of 88 are going on now at your Ford dealer. But hurry, it all ends March 8th. Get a $500 rebate on Ford F-Series trucks, the number one selling trucks in the world. Add a factory option package that includes free factory air and save over $2,600. Or get a $500 rebate on Ford Ranger, the number one selling compact pickup in America. Then save over $1,800 when you add an option package. But it all ends March 8th. The great rebates of 88.
At Hardee's, we don't use just any old fish for our fish sandwich. No. To win you over, we go to the icy depths of the North Atlantic.
A whole fillet of most flaky fish in our own special coating with real breadcrumbs and a multi-grain bun.
Next time you're in the neighborhood, why not drop in? Fisherman's fillet sandwich from Hardee's. It's the least you can do to win you over.
With Michael Jackson playing in the background, it is the University of Evansville that's bending off your pick. 45-26 first half lead here. That's kind of surprising. I didn't expect it. It's pretty much unbelievable, but everything gets split for the Ravens in the first half. Their offense looked good. They were hitting their shots. They played excellent defense. And Butler went ice cold in the second part of the first half. Frustration many times, and that may come back to hurt him in the second half. It's already hurt him, but the second half really could be a disaster for him if they keep it up. Right now, 45-26. The Aces have played a lot of players already in the first half because of the loss to Curtis Jackson on Saturday night. And for a report on that injury and a halftime update, let's go back to the Channel 14 studios where Mike Blake is standing by. Mike?
Good work. You and Dan doing a fine job. Aces again up by 19, 45-26. We've seen a little bit here. This is quite a contrast from Saturday night when we suffered a frustrating loss at the hands of Xavier, a double loss to Curtis Jackson, whose career comes to a premature close with a very serious knee injury. Yesterday, as many of you know, he underwent knee surgery. The man who performed that surgery is with me tonight, orthopedic surgeon Dr. James Rennie. Doctor, nice to have you. You called it an ascending injury, a type injury. Please explain, and I know you've got something to fill into.
Well, Curtis unfortunately sustained a deceleration type injury to the knee involving this ligament here, the anterior cruciate ligament. It's one of two ligaments that cross through the central portion of the joint. And when an athlete such as Curtis, who can generate tremendous forces, is going down the course and suddenly tries to make a sudden change of direction, it can stress that ligament beyond the point of the ligament's strength and cause its rupture. Unfortunately, this is a fairly common injury among high-speed athletes. Here on the tape, I think you can see at this point when his right leg is planted, he goes to make a sudden cut. You can see that his leg is hurt already in the air since he comes down on the left leg trying to protect the right knee. So he actually hurt it at the point of his takeoff right here by the edge of the paint.
And he knew it as he was coming down.
Yes, you'll notice how he tries to protect his leg as he's up in the air.
This is really something that really couldn't have been right. It could happen any time. It's happened to football players, too.
Right? No, that's right. He's a superbly conditioned athlete. It's just unfortunate, an unfortunate combination of forces and speeds and directions that exceeds what the knee can stand.
There were reports earlier that it happened due to the replacement of a TV camera or a peanut shell. Those were erroneous, of course. What, Doctor, with regard to the rehabilitation, I know it's a lengthy process, isn't it?
Yes, it takes a long time to heal this ligament. He'll be in a series of casts for up to 6 weeks, followed by braces, a brace for another 6 weeks, and after that, it's a long process of rehabilitation, both motion and strength. But you know, a guy as dedicated as Curtis is, will do all he can to get back into good playing shape.
I know everybody that is wishes that he could come back. If he had another year of eligibility, which he does not have, would he be able to play next year? Would the rehabilitation even be too much of next season?
Yes, I think players have to go into this figuring it'll take them a full year to get back to competitive athletics.
Dr. Jim Rennie, we appreciate you coming by. Wish you had happier news, but again, we appreciate your very kind explanation. Again, Curtis Jackson has been lost for the rest of the season, an outstanding career, and of course, as both coaches, Jim Cruz, paid tremendous compliments to him, not only after the injury, but last week, speaking to the tip-off club prior to the game with Marquette. Jim had some glowing reports of a young man that has put in four fine years here at the university, and he's certainly to be commended. And also, Pete Dillon said he has the heart of a lion. We wish Curtis a very speedy recovery. Talked to him early today, obviously a little bit down, understandably. Hopefully, he can come back and, of course, be with the team very much in spirit for the remaining games. Well, the Aces have certainly bounced back. It's been a very special weekend for several of the Aces. Some birthdays coming up, Velter Dawson and also Wilt Donald's birthdays on Wednesday. Yesterday was Marty Simmons' birthday. Marty doesn't know, but here's a birthday present to him. This cute little doll baby is one of the two most important people in his life. In addition to his wife, Angie, this is Brittany. I mean, it's Brittany Kay. Isn't she a cutie? This was taken. Dad does not know this. He'll see this when he sees a replay of the game. Good from the front, good from the back as well. How's that for a pose? Brittany, you have got it. At any rate, happy birthday to Marty. It's a happy night so far. 45-19. Coming up at 10, I'll tell you about all the MCC action. St. Louis is Xavier. It'll be nice for St. Louis to, now they want to get, they have to get beat if the Aces are going to get that second seed in the MCC tournament. It's an important one. I'll tell you about all the scores, Notre Dame in action, Southern Illinois. We'll tell you about that at 10. Right now, let's go back to Hinkle Fieldhouse to Dean Webster and Dan Cash. Fellas?
We're back at Hinkle Fieldhouse on the campus of Butler University. We're talking injuries on this halftime, and a guy that knows all about injuries, Marty Simmons, had a broken
Now, America's favorite t-shirt, making a great deal. Two medium cheese pan t-shirts, only $10.99. And toppings $1.29 each, that is both t-shirts. WFIU exclusive Doppler radar. What does it mean to you? No more ground clutter. Clear, concise, useful weather details available nowhere else. Doppler radar can zoom into storms, show a cross-section, and more, making our weathercast even more interesting and accurate. Plus, when it storms, WFIU-TV will warn you faster than ever before. WFIU exclusive Doppler radar. Another first from the station you trust. WFIU-TV, Channel 14.
Students explore the world of genetics Monday on NewsWatch at 5.
Our regularly scheduled programming will not be seen tonight in order to bring you the following WFIE special presentation. Look at this studio, filled with glamour. Including furniture to furnish your entire game. An exquisite carved jade incense burner. And this magnificent corner cabinet. Over $114,000 just waiting to be won on Wheel of Fortune. And now, here's your host.
Welcome to Wheel of Fortune. Nice to have you all with us. And now a big welcome, please, for our hostess coming through the curtains, even as I speak. Here's Vanna White. Vanna! Got a lot of stuff on her neck there. Anyway, it's time to meet our three players and get on with things. John, how you doing?
Fine.
This is John Kimball from Palo Alto, California. You are married, right?
I sure am.
And we have you listed here as a house husband, that is correct?
That I am.
And what's your wife do?
She's a structural engineer.
Fine, interesting. And you have one child, little one?
Little boy, 10 months.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, some little guy.
Okay. What's this Frisbee stuff about here?
Being involved with Ultimate Frisbee, it's like a combination of a lot of sports. Just goes crazy around. I play a lot of disc golf on Saturday mornings. I fly in deuces.
And you, do you hold a record of some kind?
For 2 million continuous throwing, just hours and hours on end in 77 edition of Guinness Book.
Yeah, how long did you do that?
Did it twice, once for 76 hours and this time for 100 hours.
Well, you must be, well, you hit the words right out of my mouth on that one. Yeah. Oh, wow. Nice to have you here, John.
Thank you.
Hi, Pam.
Hi.
So long as you've ever thrown a frisbee.
Not very long.
All right. So, from Saginaw, Michigan, you know, tell me about your life back there.
Well, I'm a housewife and I have four children, Cindy, Jason, John, and Julie. Hi.
Good.
And I also have to say hi, Dad. I've got my lucky dime.
Yeah, we have people saving a lot of money on long distance calls here. I think it's basically what's going on. It is nice to have you with us.
Thank you, Dad.
Rose, you want to get any highs out of the way here? Right off the bat, this is Rose Early of Tucson, Arizona. You have a couple of kids, right?
Yes, I have two beautiful daughters.
Yeah, and you are a secretary.
Yes.
And what else can you tell us about yourself? What keeps you busy in the state?
Well, I love to do crossword puzzles and draw, and I teach people how to read.
And I would guess that your favorite game show of all time would
is Wheel of Fortune.
A fine woman. Give that woman a Quran or something or other. $1,000 thing on the wheel, and don't hit bankruptcy. Here's our first puzzle. Thing is the category. Just before the show, we do numbers. What is that stuff you have on your neck, Vanna? Just before the show, we do numbers to see who starts the game. And John, it's going to be you. Let's go. There's 1-2. If Anna can move down there, yeah, there it is. All right.
So, in the second. Go! Come on, money, go to 1,000. 1,000. Go down. Go.
200. Two R. John, you have $700. 5 R. Okay. Two.
Buy another R.
Down to 450.
Yeah, you can buy that.
I was just chuckling at the person that hasn't heard anyone in the audience yell after a bow bind. Good purchase. Yeah, something in the air.
Go.
500. Yeah, there's an air. Now, you have $700.
Keep going.
C, and you have $1,700.
Now what? I'm blunt. Five off.
Yeah.
I.
I'm sorry. Oh, you want to use that three spin or you want to hold on to it?
Okay. No, okay.
All right, good. Yeah, Pam, your turn. And she got the 1,000, yeah.
Elsie.
Yeah, 1 L, $1,000. How many things
here? I'm going to spin.
Come on. 1,000.
300. M, please.
Say that again, please.
M as in Nancy.
Do we have an M? We do not. I'm sorry. And Rose, it's your turn.
Okay.